वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू सेशन नंबर 48 ऑफ ICF संडे वेबिनार सीरीज. अवर स्पीकर फॉर टुडे इज अंकु गोयल एंड द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज न्यू एज मीडिया द पॉडकास्ट नेटवर्क. अंकु गोयल इज द फाउंडर ऑफ इंडिया पॉडकास्ट विच इज अ नेशनल ऑडियो वीडियो मीडिया चैनल एंड शी विल हेल्प अस अंडरस्टैंड द न्यू एज मीडिया मॉडल ऑफ ऑडियो विजुअल ऑडियो वीडियो पॉडकास्ट through her personal journey and some tools that equipped her to build her platform. So over to you, Anku.
Thank you so much, Vivek. Thank you so much, Venkatraman sir, for inviting me on this interesting platform and in discussion. And thank you so much, Jyoti, also for letting me into this space and meeting all of you. It's a Sunday. I hope you enjoy it. And as everybody is quiet, I would love to have people coming on screen and we can all see each other because it makes it more lively. Hi, so I like the vibrant backgrounds. I like yours, ma'am. It's so cute. And I'd be really happy if required anyone can just interrupt and make points or anything, because actually I feel like I'm too young here to, not young by age, but young in terms of my experience to come and share anything. And yet I've been privileged that all of you think I have done decent work in life. So just to begin with, when I say New Age Media Platform, the podcast network, I simply want to bring it in perspective to India for that matter, because podcast, as we all understand today, or we go to understand in time again, is little more less adapted in this country yet. So we come it across as a New Age model today, because we see that we have seen podcasts grow in other countries, especially states. It's been over a decade that a podcast has been a more easier way of listening to an information or communicating with each other. My understanding goes, the reason being that we're not a good listener, or media in India is not related to being good listeners, but good anchors, good hosts, good moderators, but we don't know how to listen. And it's not that we do it by purpose, but we simply don't know how to listen. And we only believe in listening to the content which is fed to us in a particular manner, which is more spoon fed. We have no judgment as to what should, how can we self filter the content. But podcast is a space, I believe, which doesn't spoon feed you at all. You have lots of genre. It's like an open playing field for everyone. To begin with, somebody asked me, how is podcast different from radio? Because a radio jockey apparently could be doing same thing as a podcaster does. They have the same mic setup, little new mic style, and all you need to do is talk and, you know, give your views on thing. But when an RJ or radio jockey goes on air to talk, they are regulated and limited to a lot of factors where a podcaster might not have that limitation. When a radio jockey might be speaking, they have a sense of entertainment involved in it, which is a major part for people to listen, because music is part of the radio world. You switch on to a radio station, if we just keep the All India Radio aside, but the other stations for music, you want to relax. And in between, the RJs keep trying their best to entertain you, but most of them fail, because I think people keep switching, ye kab band karega and I can listen to the song, you know. It's more about music than what he says. So the New Age platform, when you say podcast, it's a very interesting space, because one, it allows people who want to do podcasts or create podcasts to get to their own creative quality. Now, everybody is not comfortable with the visual exposure of coming on camera. Now we are forced to, because we are on Zoom, and I'm so liking that everybody's so happy. The camera zoomed on their face, they're okay. Earlier, I remember when we were journalists and television journalists, without the basic foundation, we don't want to go because it could see our wrinkles. But now I think everybody's okay with the camera bang on their faces. But yet, we are not so okay to face the world with it. Podcast has helped you reach yourself out without people judging how you look, from where are you coming, what is your...
You lost your voice.
You lost my voice only. Wow.
Yeah, it's back.
So like we say, when you look at a person's eye, you can judge the genuinity of a person. Similarly, if you can't see someone, their voice can help you know how you connect to that person. There's a very strong connecting factor for any two individual across age and generation. Podcast helps you utilize that. So I'm just generically making my understanding on podcast, which attracted me was when I heard my first podcast exposure was with Anthony Ponce, Ponce or Ponce, you can call him. He's a journalist in Canada, if I'm not wrong, with the location there. And he was a TV anchor. And apparently he might have been good in his space of journalism for a decade. And then he left his job. And I suddenly, while searching around,
voice. Maybe a loose contact, loose connection somewhere.
Is it okay now?
Yeah.
So I was talking about Anthony Ponce, who I checked onto his profile while searching about him. This was a young TV journalist who lost his job. And after a decade of anchoring in a very renowned television channel, their regional channel, though, to say so, and in Chicago, not Canada, yeah, in Chicago. And I remember that I was watching the video where he comes out and he picturized his exit from the office in a video. There was just a video and the man moving out of his office with his with all that he had collected over years. And there was a video and a very charming young man. So I was more attracted to him. And there were some lines written about what he was thinking. He said, "I lost my job, you know, what do I do?" And he was not speaking, but it was just written down and there was a music. And then this guy says that I'm going to join to be a taxi driver now. And who doesn't want to have such a nice taxi driver? You know, he started something called the backseat rider. I thought, what is he flaunting? What's so new? And then he reveals in his next show that he's become the backseat rider podcaster, individual entrepreneur, doing nothing. He left a big amount of money. He rejected his job and he became a taxi driver. He had a family to start also. What he did, he placed a mic behind. He placed a camera later on, and anybody he gives a ride in his taxi, all he requested them was, "Can you please share your story? Anything you want to share." Whether it was an old woman, a young man, a lady, they would love to just share what was in their head. He started with the idea, "Can you just share what's going in your head while I'm riding you back?" And they would share, and he would record it, the entire conversation, and then stream it through Apple Podcasts, which is new, I think, 6 years back. In the States to come up on that. And he would just play it out via Apple Podcasts and somehow push it through his Facebook that, "Please listen to this. This is a story of some people, the real people." And he had his basic following, but still people wanted to listen, but nobody could see things. Later, he put in a camera. I think within 8 months, this boy made a difference as he could get so many life stories from their own mouth. He had a story of a 90-year-old woman talk about how she suffered her marriage all these years, and she was emotional while she was riding back, and she thanked that boy that, "Thanks for allowing me such a beautiful ride." But all he saw after 8 months was he could not make money. He gained a lot of love, success, but no money. So there was a point when Anthony came and announced that, "Thanks for supporting me, thanks for following me. I would have to close this because I'm looking for a job now. I have just given, my wife has given birth to a son and I need to take care of him." But to his surprise, a week later, Fox not just bought the entire podcast, they hired him. Today, he's the backseat rider podcast doer in Fox News. And this was something by surprise in his life. But the idea that struck me with Anthony Ponce's video was podcast was not limited to only one way of doing it. It has a creative openness. He used his creative edge of recording the camera aspect of the rider, because people also want to see is what is now the podcaster started to develop. We do definitely want to listen, but there's an element of wanting to watch as well. There I came with the idea of audio video podcast. So I don't have a story like Anthony, though my channel closed. I was working with Business Television India, where Anil Ambani made sure that we are bankrupt as much as he is. And we were overnight, I think, thrown out of the company and the company was closed, but for good for my life, because I then realized what media was doing in India was more about creating news or exaggerating news or getting us to repeat what we already know. So when I got this opportunity of bringing podcasts, I was covering banks because I was a banking reporter. I remember I went to a few of the bankers, the SBI MD, Mr. Rajneesh Kumar, when I lost my job. I just met him for greeting purpose. And I told him that I want to record your experience of COVID. The COVID had struck in then on phone. And he said, "But what would you get out of it? Who knows, you know, who will listen and what is it?" I said, "It's a podcast." And he said, "What do you mean?" I said, "It's something new. You don't know about it." He's like, no, is that a new age thing? I was like, of course it is the new age thing. It's only done in America. And he bought the idea. He's like, wow, I would like to do it. And the man who was only available with a brand name just told me, how do we do it? I was like, all you need to do is talk to me on phone. So podcast, I will come to the technicals in just a few minutes, is not limited to only recording it using a lot of setup or a console. If you are capable of just recording your voice and whatever you want to say, suppose you want to do a monologue or you want to involve someone into a conversation or what we are doing today, even that can be made into a podcast, which is basically a creative streaming of an audio conversation. The actual meaning of podcast is informal chat. So suppose we all are starting off, when you don't plan your conversation, when you go with the moment, like we came on board and I just like your faces. So my podcast can begin with how beautiful it is. You know, I've never seen such faces in my time. I mean, altogether. So why not, you know, begin it like that? Or somebody having a coffee and you can just begin your conversation. Like, how's your coffee? Is it better than mine? Can you prove it now? So any conversation that allows you to just be yourself, and yet it helps the listeners to connect to yourself, is called a podcast today, is what I understand. It is non-scripted because it allows you to, everybody is looking for relatability in each other. The kind of new films we are seeing, the Netflix generation, we want to watch things where we feel relatable. And relatability only comes when I feel like I can do what you're doing. It is not something I need to get certified for. I think that informal version of the radio element has got podcasts popular. So I remember when I went to Rajneesh Kumar and he called me on phone and he said, what do I have to do? I just kept on asking him some questions for 10 minutes. And then he said, Anku, but when are we going to record the podcast? As if we are done, I've recorded you. My phone is recorded. And then I edited the conversation, the phone recording that I had. And we just edited in the most creative manner we could. We made some promo, some highlights, and we streamed it through. There are various applications that are available that allows your podcast to stream through 5 or 6 platforms. So I use something called Spreaker, where you can upload an MP3 file. So my edited file could be uploaded there, which automatically gives me an option to stream it through Spotify, Apple, Google. There's an application called Spreaker, Spreaker, which is not very popular.
I missed that app or whatever you're using. What did you say?
Spreaker. Spreaker.
S-P-I. Okay, okay.
Speaker. S-P-R-E-K. Speaker mein ek R laga hua hai. Speaker.
Okay.
So I use this platform because this was uncommon and I was really insecure. I didn't want people to cheat. I was like on my high that I'm going to do it differently. So I got my first SBI chairman. Then I got the Medanta chairman. Then I got all the bank MDs, and all they did to agree to me was, is this something new? Are people going to listen to me? And it really happened. What people did not want to listen to the same person on the television news channel video, they were happy listening to him on the audio. Because when people talk on audio, their expression, their hindrance, their hesitation.
Voice.
I can hear myself.
Yeah. Okay, voice is back.
So I think a podcast also allows everyone to feel free into conversations that they do. You might have come across something called Audible, which is the Apple storytelling app. The idea that people started resonating with the idea of podcasts was it allows you to not just host it very easily, but even the listeners can understand the concept in a more picturized manner. We are used to storytelling like from our childhood, from decades and generations. Like when we sleep, the child even today says, give me a story. And they don't want to see it because your eyesight's so weak. All you need to do is tell them a story which they can imagine. So another important element of podcasts is it should create a visual imagination. If you're recording a podcast of a serious nature, creative nature, even a news or a music or a poetry, a beautiful poetry podcast, there's some famous poetry podcasters, it should have the power to visually create that image in the listener's mind. You can play with the voice. You can play with your way of talking. It's just a storytelling idea in different ways. So that element allowed me to set up my platform because I started as an audio podcaster and I went forward to recording my shows on Zoom with the guest. I like that. And then we after recording the video podcast, like we started with maybe one guest a week or 2 weeks, and we are now at 3 or 4 guests a week. We have covered like 135 guests from all sectors, Raghuram Rajan to Kapil Dev, to bankers, to all the RBI governors, to all the actors, directors, Shekhar Kapoor, I mean, other Poonawala, everybody. Because the idea was, most important idea for India podcast was that we are used to interrupting people when they talk. And we are used to asking wrong people to talk on wrong topics. Like if I had a other with me, I don't think I need to say above him what a vaccine means. So I started giving my platform to people who excel in their area of comfort, of knowledge, of expertise, and there let people develop a habit of listening. So when I did P. Sainath or other people, a lot of people told me, hey, you don't counter them. Hey, why do you let them talk at length? Why are you handing over your show to them? I said, but I don't think I'm making more sense than them anyway. I can just pull out the right points to them and they can choose. So that was my idea of pulling through the podcast, because I wanted people to listen to it. But podcast is not limited to one aspect. Audio visual podcast is a new area where you see even the radio jockeys now come on video. The idea is to get more relatable and to make people believe that, yes, we can also do what you're doing. So that was the larger aspect I wanted to tell you about the New Age podcast. The statistics here tell us that India is the third biggest consumer for podcasts. Now, there must be a reason why. Why suddenly we have gone to listening and not watching? I think with the lockdown coming in majorly and with the bad negative impact that the media has played in displaying some images out there, false news, a lot of put off has already happened. And especially with the lockdown, I saw a lot of tendency of going and watching films in theater shifted. People started looking for more good content because they had more time to spare to themselves, that what they want to listen and put in themselves. Earlier, we were used to just watching what is fed to us. It was more of a push culture. What we tell you, you have to watch. Today, we are in a culture where they say what we want to watch or see, you want to choose that. So in this area of choice, the digital platform has itself found its next leap that we were waiting for, because digital platform is the only platform which allows you to stream through content for free. Whether you use a YouTube, you use a Spotify, you use an Apple podcast, Spreaker, you're not charged, but a minimal cost for audio podcast and almost no cost for YouTube. Your viewers will decide whether you're good or not. So that challenge has also led to a very easy platform for anyone to start doing anything. Like any one of us can be a podcaster or a video journalist or a video caster by just taking up the cause and streamlining how we want to go about it. So that was a major reason that the stats in India also started drifting, because we started watching more of Netflix. We started following more of the foreign content to understand and get better knowledge and better information, where I think we were still lacking. We were more prone to watching 24/7 news channel, which got a major setback during the lockdown. People were escaping bad news. They were trying to watch new films. And there was a time we had no films also due to cable lockout and everything. So I think then these digital element and podcasts came as an escape. And that's how we find the space being utilized. If we look at the technical aspect of how a podcast is done, if anyone tomorrow wants to start it or today, there are various apps. The most popular of them is Anchor, which is an app that you can download for free. It's called A-N-C-H-O-R. And there's another app called Spreaker, which allows you to edit your audio and then put it out as an MP3. So Anchor allows you auto editing. There is when you record your voice in Anchor app, there's a button which allows you to edit and kill out the ambient sound without using any external element. And similarly, Spreaker allows
audio gone.
Hi, audio is gone.
Oh, were you missing out a lot of it?
No, just a bit. You spoke about Anchor and Spreaker.
Yes, I spoke about Anchor and Spreaker as the host platform.
Yes.
Now, when you record Anchor, it allows you to edit your sound. There's an auto edit button which allows to treat your audio. It will remove the ambient sounds. It will clear the hitch in the voice and everything. For Spreaker, you can edit your entire podcast separately. Mm. You can get someone to edit it to you and convert into MP3 file and just upload it over there. All the host platforms of podcast, Spotify hosting is a little complicated, so I personally don't advise, because anywhere you host your podcast, you can stream it through the other platforms. Every hosting podcast platform has an option of check-in. You can choose as many podcast platforms you can check it into. They are all internally collaborated. So even if you host it on Anchor or Spreaker, Spotify, Apple, Google, iHeartRadio, CastBox, Podcast Beans, they already are checked in. You can just select them. So your show will also be streamed over there. But the count and the statistics will be measured in your host platform. You can't measure how many people downloaded in Spotify, but your host platform, there will be a statistics button to know how many people saw or heard your podcast, to get a sense of it. Now, this is a very simple way that I told you. Genuinely, when a good podcast show comes up, you might have seen a setup comes up. There's a podcast mic. There's a people sitting across setup that we do. Now, the idea for doing that kind of podcast is actually sitting across and chatting informally to let the other person speak their mind and not plan and script it out. The mic is the device. You have a lot of podcasting mics available that allows you again to clear your tone, and the podcaster's voice should be a little loud and intimidating, very, very attractive, because the whole purpose of the listening to you. Visual element has come in now, but the major aspect of podcast is to listen to the audio, listen to the conversation. So the mic plays a very important role, at least for the podcast hoster, to clearly identify himself or herself as who you are and how you speak. There are people who love to kiss the mic and do it. Like, they almost stick themselves to the mic, because then if you don't have a naturally husky voice, you can feel that thing. Then you can do some romantic, good movie podcast and bring it like in the public. I've seen some people do that. Then there are varieties to it, but the major setup is sitting across the table and then chatting your heart out. That's how you present it. But to be cost efficient in the time we are, the mics don't cost you much, but a setup would cost you 5,000 to 8,000. Or you can just use a lapel mic to your phone. That is 1,000 rupee set that comes. Attach the cord to your phone, record the entire podcast in your phone, edit it out and upload it. That's also one of the ways to do it. So these are a few of the ways that we see podcasts in India has been streaming now. If you go abroad, there's some famous podcasters, Joe Rogan, or Rogan, how you call him. He's one of the world's big...
Little louder, please.
Guest.
Your background noise has taken over.
Yeah.
Some background noise from somewhere.
And Anku, maybe a little slowly. Like when you are saying these names, I'm not catching them, but I'm making notes.
Okay. So it is Joe, R-O-G-A. He has a website.
Little louder.
Why am I losing your voice today?
A little louder.
Hi, Joe
Rogan, R-O-G-A-N.
Thank you.
Your voice gone again. Maybe AC is on or fan is on in the background?
I think so. Just give me a moment. Let me see that.
Well, that's okay. Let her be comfortable.
No, I think this is not getting easy.
No, there must be a loose
fan. We can hear you now. Just...
Are you sure?
Yeah. Suddenly for a few seconds we lose you, then you come back. It should be okay.
Okay. So we have a few famous podcasters in the world, and their agenda of podcasting is again having a very lighthearted, individual, informal chat, which is why this got popular in the States. I think I'm losing out the vision. Are you able to see me? Am I stuck?
You have become stuck.
I can't see you and I can't hear you well. Please speak more loudly. You're so beautiful. I love to hear you.
Anku can't see you, but we can hear you, I think.
Yeah, I think...
You've gone to the podcast mode now.
Can hear you loudly.
I had that, when we started. And for a long time, she didn't switch on her video. I was wondering if she's such a strong podcaster, she's only going to speak.
can you hear me?
I can hear you. I think my video got stuck or something.
I can do something. You want me to log in from my phone?
Do it simultaneously, no? Like the way you did.
Yeah, I'm just putting it on my phone as well so that we don't lose the content.
Just so we see two speakers.
Yes, you'll have two same looking speakers today. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
I can't see any one of you. Can you see me?
Yeah, we can.
Better. Much better, I think.
We can see you.
Yeah,
and you can hear you. Yeah, we can
hear you. The phone is much clearer. You were right.
Kani is gone. She said you are very beautiful. So you must be more beautiful now. Kani is gone, missing from here now.
Oh, she left. She got offended.
No. She must have got disconnected or something.
I think this is the only limitation we sometimes face in this Zoom world that we are into.
I was also curious about your DP, you know.
Oh, that was
an ashram.
That was in Bangalore. It was in Shri Shri Ravi Shankar's ashram.
It was also very nice.
That is the vibe of that ashram that makes you all feel so blessed.
Mm-hmm.
It was back in 2012. But are we all together now? Everybody is joining?
Yes.
Okay. So coming back to the whole understanding, when I started India Podcast, as I told you, it started with the audio, it went into video. Now we have collaborated to making it not limited to interviews, but podcast is more than interviews. So we had done one interview with director Shekhar Kapoor. We had called the series The Turning Point of Life. So all we did, since he has an amazing voice and he has an amazing storytelling ability, he talks in a very calm and composed manner. I will share it with you soon because we can't upload it here. When I interacted with him, I think after Sushant Singh Rajput's death, the very next day, he had such a nice way of holding on to telling us what life is, what turning point in his life was, and how stardom can be taken wrong. But the way he narrated the story to us on a Zoom audio, what we did was we took his audio. We have a graphic team and we have a filmmaker team with us in my India Podcast group. These are young filmmakers. Some have been training in London, some are working as DOP somewhere, but very, very like 20, 23 or old. We are like 4-people team. What they did with Shekhar's voice, they collaborated the visuals whichever way they could in their creativity and edited out beautiful videos, and then we streamed it out. So visual need not be only of the person who's talking in the podcast. If I'm talking to you today and I record the conversation, I can make a podcast by removing you from the picture, using your voice and covering it with what you're talking about. They can be visuals, they can be pictures relevant to your conversation. So how you edit it, how you package is much dependent on you than. Are we there?
Yeah.
So Shekhar's podcast also got very popular. And then we tried Pankaj Tripathi's. He also was a very good narrator. So his vision about, like, he told us, I would love to walk on a beach near my house in Mud Island. I wish I could be doing this. Zindagi ki kuch shayari boli unhone Hindi mein. So what we did is when he was talking that, we took a visual of an old man walking on the beach. And we played that up over his voice. So we saw people quite enjoy that. Now, another important element in a podcast is time and duration. You cannot hold a podcast too long, if not so required, until it is a very important interview. Generally, people appreciate maximum of average listening time we saw was 5 minutes. So whatever you can create an impact is in the first 5 minutes of your listening. That's a high average time that you can say. Otherwise, there's a tendency of people switching on within few seconds. So whenever we upload our podcast, the long form podcast is nearly 25 minutes. We upload it only on YouTube. And of course, we stream. We convert the MP4 into MP3 and put it on the speaker and get the audio podcast streamed out. So that's our technique of doing it. Some people do direct audio podcast. They record 15 minutes is the maximum average good podcast that you should go for. That's the maximum upper limit. We don't think people really want to sit through more than 10 minutes also, because there is a listening capacity that we have in our natural tendency to continuously listen to any story. So time and duration really plays an important role in getting your podcast there. The most challenging part of podcast compared to any visual media platform is the reach, distribution, and getting people to believe in it. And the most important aspect to your distribution and marketing is consistency. I think we maintained our consistency till we could do 100 podcasts. So first 5 podcasts, even if we get the biggest of the name, we never got a good listener amount. I started with my podcast a download count of 10 a week, 12 a week. And today I'm sitting on 35,000 overall. So I see people get tuned to it when you have a consistent play out. It is not broken. Even if I improvised in my technique in between, I never stopped producing it. Earlier, my podcast was a little old school. The editing was done by me. While doing it, I got a new team. They edited it more polished way, but I never stopped producing it. The consistency helps people to, by default, go and check. Arey, fir kuch aa gaya, fir dekh leta hu. You know, it's kind of like putting in their mouth. If you don't like something, I'll make you taste it again. Someday you might like it. Or someday out of nothing else to listen to, you might just end up listening to me. So that's the tendency of getting there. So consistency has been a major key player. Second is, of course, the content. Although content becomes first, but you have to keep juggling between the both. Sometimes even good content is the toughest to sell on digital platforms. People who have millions of followings are the ones who are doing random things. You know, you see girls selling video makeup podcast, random things. They have millions of followers. They're influencers in the country today. Anyone teaching you how to dress up is more influential than anyone telling you how to live a better life until you are a Sadhguru. So what we really see is people don't really want to listen to things that make sense. All they want to listen to is something that gives them off gear, don't make sense. So the quality of content has to be looked at by looking at what you're giving out should be entertaining. Even if it is a more serious content that you want to bring out, a sense of... Did I lose out anyone? Okay. Are we there?
Yeah.
So the content quality is not just limited to what you want to say. It is also limited to how you want to say it. And we have quite experimented through and seen that entertainment aspect is the most important key for anyone to watch you. Because every day people are anyway getting gyan from every place, everything. They can themselves go. The only thing that pulls them up is like, what am I going? Can I smile through it? Or can I feel relaxed through it? So whatever you do, you have to bring that aspect to it. So content, quality, consistency, these two C's are the most important. Then is the duration. The shorter, the better. The crisper, the better. And you should always leave your audience with something they can look forward to. It should not feel like I just want to have this much and not the next time. So your end of the content should also be much looking forward to, like you have to wait for what's coming ahead, or leave them in answering something that you haven't answered in this podcast. Like we've heard so many health podcasts. I think even Luke Contino, one of the biggest nutritionists who had come on our show, said, I'm going to launch my own podcast channel because he wants, and he's much, much followed in the country by youngsters today. And all he does is he sits quietly and keeps giving gyan about how to live. But that's not resonating everyday basis. He said, I'll try something new and funky to bring out that. I remember when we interacted with Dr. Shashi Tharoor, he had the same thing. He said, I went on to stand-up comedy show because I wanted people to also understand the funnier part of me, which is again his personality. And so entertainment, consistency, quality, these are aspects, but duration does play a major role. The better you are in entertaining in a shorter period, the better you see people glue to you. Because today's generation doesn't have time to go through anything for long. They like, move on. When you come to the presentation of a podcast, I didn't know this. I didn't believe in it until I really had to. Your thumbnails that you use as a cover of your podcast is really an important aspect of people to click on it. I used to reject it that I don't believe in it, you know. I don't want to. But I started using my pictures and I saw, okay, that's another way to fool someone. So not to say in the other way, but yes, thumbnails and designing there, we do think it's a waste, but certainly it matters. Because I think everybody is looking for something good to look at because we like to look at good presentation, good feel. Once that comes in and then you make sense, then trust me, you'll go a long way. There is no coming back to it. So these are the experiences I had. And I think the world of podcasts is even more evolving because the OTT platforms are coming into it now. We have Hotstar coming up with their own podcast network. So they would be converting good content, good storytelling content into it. Fiction podcast is coming into play. I think Spotify is doing a lot of podcasts on unique professions in the country. So a lightman story, a truck driver story. So whatever stories can be visually presented through the audio medium is called a podcast today. And it's actually finding people more easy to listen to because people have changed their lifestyle now over time. They don't want to get glued to the phones and spoil their eyesight. A lot of visuals go into their head while sleeping, but listening and sleeping is less hazardous than watching. And even the most important thing is youngsters' learning is happening through podcasts. Even the universities are coming out with podcasts for teaching youngsters and the children how to go about the education model because they have found that they don't stay and watch one thing. They will watch something, they will listen to something else, they'll do so many things together. So you thought, let us just get to the audio and get them a better way of enjoying things in life. So that's a very crisp and a very short, simple way I could explain it to you. I didn't want to go too technical or confuse you with how difficult it can get because when I started off, I had to Google every day and I was like, I don't have so much money. I can't put a podcast mic. I can't put a studio. I don't have a banner. People told me use a green banner, a chroma wall. There are ready-made element on Zoom that you can use. But I avoided all that because the better you keep it natural, the easier for you to do it every day. So I started using the corners of my house, plain wall, bookshelves, even though we don't read, but we all have books to show off as if we read. I like Jyoti's background. You give a sense of that whole, I don't know, you belong to some like coming old days, you know?
Old Bengal.
Yeah. And I can see Venkatraman giving me a feel of this whole London kind of a feel in his house.
That's a simple background.
Yeah, which we can make up for work well too. And as we know, all the ladies in India, we like to go into the camera. We just love it. We don't take too much. I think I'm waiting for women to do podcasts from kitchen. I have been missing that. I really wish women can stand in the kitchen because that's the most, I mean, that's where I see my mother spend her time. If given a choice to have a bed there, she would sleep over there. I wish there was a choice that we had these kind of natural elements.
What about cooking vlogs and all that happen? Video logs.
I think we should talk. Women should talk about their relationship. Men from
kitchen. Then why from the kitchen?
Because the food is the way to make to the man's heart, is what we Indian women were told. So I think they should actually start there and remind the men that this is what I made for you. And you're running because of the food that I've created in this hot kitchen, you know. I keep telling my mother, your man should know that it is you who is running him, not his money.
No, so I know one lady at least who used to tell us, she's so many years ago, but even now, okay, she's doing the kitchen very old, 90 plus. She used to tell us, I would just like to, you know, just die cooking. Okay, very old person.
She would like to die cooking.
Yeah, that's what she used to tell us, okay. Very, very...
I think that would be because she loves to cook.
And yeah, she loves to cook. Yeah. She loves to cook.
Reason. That's a passion. So, yeah.
But I think it's nice because this platform has allowed people to feel free that they can also do. You don't need a professional space to go because to be a radio jockey, there's a lot to do. They make you feel like your voice is not gifted. It's such a rubbish thing you've got. But with podcasting, you've got the edit element. So everybody's voice looks the same. Rather better than what they can show. So I think it's a good platform that allows us to reach out.
But it also helps. Sorry for the interruption, but I guess it also helps if you have voice modulation and you know how pitch works. So, like, you know how to play with your voice.
It is required to an extent if you can do that. But honestly, when I saw that when you are just being as natural, but continuously being natural, like we have so become artificial that we realize that we become natural sporadically and artificial throughout. If we can go back to being how we are naturally, as natural as each one of us are, like if I am talking in a certain way, it has to be as natural on my show. Like in my show, I often go yawning also because that's how I am. So, I see people quite, my listeners also write that in this one, you're not yawn enough. I was like, okay, so there is a connection that people are developing. So whatever is your own personality, it gets recognized if it is true. Because I think that that's how you are. Like I would make a very stupid example, but when we had this movie, Hum Aapke Hai Kaun, we had Madhuri doing that uhu uhu thing. And that also got so connected with people as if it was something so natural, you know, because everyone has that natural tendency of fumbling, doing something funny, unusual, so unpolished. And that is what makes podcast world more real. Because when you go into a radio world or something very professional, you have to go into the rules and standard out. But with this, I think it's your playing field. You play it the way you want and you're through.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Anku. A very refreshing presentation today. And over to the participants now for their queries.
One, as you mentioned something about somebody doing unique, you know, professions. Vivek, I want you to take note of that, okay?
I am also coming out.
It's a unique profession, right? So, you mentioned somebody's, you know.
Yes, professions that are there. Spotify is doing a show on that. Mm. A very, very rare found profession. The night job doers. People who are doing something which is not identified as a good profession as yet. Even I'm working on a series called Beyond the Judgment. So we are trying to collaborate and sell our podcast to Netflix and work with them to create a nonfiction series called Beyond the Judgment. So that would be more about how people have stumbled their own judgment space in, you know, in their lives and overcome it or fail to overcome it. But I think life has grown beyond the judgment. So that's one of the stories that we are doing. Then we have a story like Turning Point of Life. Everybody has a turning point. So in this podcast, we are going to visually take people back to where they had the turning point. Suppose you say, I had a turning point when I was walking out of my school gate and suddenly that struck to me. We go back with you to that school gate when you're narrating that story. If it exists, if it doesn't exist, we recreate it by the kind of ambience we can. So podcasts will allow you either visually or with your audio to create imaginary element and then tell people your story. So that is what it gives you power to do. So anything that you think I can be more descriptive about or I missed on?
Let me ask you a question about, you know, this terminology, okay? See, video, we understand what is video. Podcast, I understood as simply audio. Okay. Now, when I read the term audio, video, podcast, I had my own doubts. Again, I checked the net, okay, before I actually put it in there. Then I saw the term is there. Now, what does that term actually signify? Does it include, you know, the, as you said, person being natural when they are talking, but then the video, you add it to, you know, to gel with the whatever is being said there.
So
can
the
you explain something about the terminology there?
So the terminology, ideally it started with audio podcast. That is how it was known when it began. The whole podcast platform was supposed to be audio streaming of content. That is how this started. It took into the video casting element. It was called video cast. It was not even called audio video podcast. It was called a video cast. It started, and they started creating the podcast with a visual presence of putting some, they call this, there's a technical term used for putting the pictures and mixing it with the audio. So there's a technical term. I'm just missing that term out, which we also use when we tell the editors. So you add those relevant pictures. If I'm talking about life, I used to walk on a road. Then you have a road visual coming around. The idea of doing that was people while listening again wanted a visual interpretation of it. It helps you connect more and more. The interview format of audio video podcast is something now recently started, that anyone who's doing an interview on the audio podcast wants themselves to be seen. so that people also want to start knowing who we are listening every day. You see, the radio jockeys also start doing the visual recording of their, I mean, it would never happen. You could never know who the radio jockey is beyond their voice. Today, you see all of them streaming it. So maybe the platform has also given that privilege to all of them. YouTube has also given them monetizing elements. So people, once you do video podcast, you can put it on YouTube. Once your podcast is popular, you get monetized. You need 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 average view hours to get in the monetization list. So I think only by doing audio podcast, the monetization limit is very limited because it's a new space. Downloads matter, likes matter, the duration of listening matters. When you go into the video space, it allows you to stream the podcast on the video platforms, which can further pay you when you look at the commercial aspect. The same podcast is visually there on YouTube, and YouTube is very good in returning you the count if you're doing well. Same as Facebook. In fact, they give you ad credits also if they like your work and the consistency. So I think it's also because of the commercial aspect and the idea that it helps you better understand. But originally, podcast was a non-formal audio conversation. It had nothing to do with video or anything. That's how it began.
You mentioned something about OTT, okay? I mean, I don't know anything about OTT, but I thought it's got something to do with movies because it's been in the news for some time. How does that connect with... You mentioned something about...
I mentioned the Hotstar OTT platform is working on... In fact, JioSaavn has started the podcast platform as well. They are already an audio platform, but they are streaming interviews and video interviews of podcast nature on their platform. Are you there? Did I lose you?
Yeah. So can you explain this OTT? What is this OTT?
So OTT, basically, all the platforms like your Netflix to your Hotstar, Amazon, Z5, wherever you're seeing this complete content voice aggregation.
We lost you.
Can you hear me now? Am I audible?
Yeah, yeah.
So content aggregators, which started with Netflix, Amazon, and Hotstar, where they brought together the already streamed content. When Netflix began, all it did was already published movies were there available to watch.
Okay.
Then it started something called Netflix Originals, where people and production team went to them with a script and they had money and they said, okay, we'll make it with you. So when we go to Netflix or a Hotstar or Amazon, they gave us two options. Either we take the script to them, they buy it and they make it. Or you make the content and they buy it at one go and the viewership money is their money. That's the revenue model they have.
Okay.
OTTs have now started seeing the popularity of the podcast and they're going to have a platform where all the good podcasts will be aggregated together. Just like the movies were aggregated together, the content. Now you will see OTT platforms also used for aggregating podcasts. So if they buy my podcast, you will see India Podcast on an OTT platform. That's also an option they would look for. Or maybe one of my series will be bought out by OTT because Netflix originally can't take our audio content now. If I give them a Shekhar Kapoor visual audio content, they will not take it because they want fiction drama. They're limited to fiction drama or a non-fiction drama. But to take our audio podcast content, they have to start a platform where people can go only to listen or visually listen to something. So it's a space they are trying to commercialize on basis the kind of volume of reach. I mean, Joe Rogan has 13 million followers. I mean, who can follow audio podcast for so many, you know, such a number? So people genuinely listen. India is still coping with that space. We are yet not there, but we are being experimental in every manner to be there. Because as I said, we don't want to listen. We just want to be told what to listen. We can't listen by our own sense. So that's the world we are in. But I think Spreaker and Anchor are two great platforms to utilize because it is commonly downloaded. And if you want to market it, do check in Spotify because everybody by default is more addicted to Spotify than other platforms. And of course, Apple Podcasts are there in few phones. Not everybody holds an Apple phone for that matter. So that's how things have been streaming out. In fact, you might have heard iHeartRadio have started doing collaboration with Anupam Kher, where Anupam does storytelling on their podcast. So celebrities are hosting their podcast on different platforms. And India Podcast as an aggregator I'm developing, where I will calling on more of content. Suppose you make a podcast series tomorrow, I would be putting it on my website. So I'm allowing more and more people to come with variety content and plug in the content on one platform. That's the idea I'm looking for.
Yeah, Anku, I have a question for you. I was like discussing it with Jyoti also. So the query is...
Allow me just 5 seconds for that matter. I'll just put this on.
Sure, sure.
I really wanted to show you also some of the podcasts, but I am not very equipped with the LinkedIn right now. But I would give you the names and you can definitely search it around. It's really interesting if you watch some of them. Yeah, we can go ahead with the question. Sorry.
Yeah, the question is, how do you manage to get the big names?
Oh,
it's that's been a very important point for Vivek. Huh?
It's been a journey, sir. It's been a journey. So how I get is a lot of media guest coordinators are my friends in NDTV and other platforms, other channels. So they give me direct number and I'm little brazen and fearless. I've had many celebrities to block me also. Just 1 second.
Vivek, sir, I guess perks of being a former journalist because she has been in the media sector. So she has the contacts and she can, and she tries to find out the contacts.
Yes, Suchira, that applies to you also. So I think you can help us.
I'll try to. Thank you. I'll try my best.
But honestly, it is not because of belonging to journalism. It was because once you get the number, you can't directly write to them. But I have been someone who's directly wrote to them. And the way I sold myself, my product out was different. I used to say it's a national audio video podcast network. And my name was unique. It was called India Podcast. So I saw most of the celebrities actually believe in the aspect and the way I said. Like I remember Raghuram Rajan, I required 4 mails and he clearly said a no. And then I had to write a very rough mail at 2 a.m. in the night, saying, if you think I have to be a Shireen Bhan to interview you or Lata to interview you, I have no such aim in my life. I'm a young girl from Calcutta. And all I thought was you were good enough for me to, you know, I had the knowledge to interview you. And he agreed then. So sometimes it's fight, sometimes it's constant pursuit. I got Barkha after 4 months. I got P. Sainath after 3 months. So I have made a list of like 200 people I keep writing to. Some block me. I had little work at with Konkana Sen. Then with Farah Khan. So I've had my days of understanding and missing out. But yeah, it was the convincing help because the brand name also helps. So name also matters a lot. If you start a podcast with your individual name, it might be a challenge.
Yeah.
So always choose a name which is more relatable generically. Like India Podcast resonated to everyone. Oh, is it a national stuff? What is it? Yeah. I was like, okay, so it's easier to convince people. Otherwise, it always out. Why do I go to an individual platform? So I've seen a podcast that was called Break the Cycle, which was very interesting. So I've seen people come up with nice names. Somebody, a poetry podcast is called The Honest Poetry. So something which is more, I still believe a generic term is much better to connect than any specific term. It helps.
Yeah, thanks.
I would like to invite all of you to one of my shows. I have a caller segment in all my shows. I have Hardeep Singh Puri coming on Wednesday, the aviation minister. And I have a very interesting girl, Zoya Agarwal, who flew the North Pole, also joining us on the show about her journey. So we have Anupam Kher coming in later. We have few of the guests coming around for their book launches and stuff. So it'll be really nice if any of the guests is interesting. I put out a lot of creatives. You can check my Instagram as India Podcast. We do a lot of creative marketing. So to market it on Instagram, we do a lot of story making. We have a one person graphic team. So she makes out story. Like if we want to invite a guest, we put out a shout out, ask what you want to particular guests. Then people send us questions. We have to convince the celebrity to share it. Their following helps us reach a larger mass. Otherwise it got difficult. So my reason of taking celebrity was to help present this name on a larger platform because I am not that popular at all. for a Barkha or a Fade D'Souza, it's a little easier because they are known in the world. So yeah, that all aspect you have to figure out. Like, how do you want to market it?
Yeah, but they would also have started somewhere. Like, everyone's journey starts from step zero, I would say. Then you take one step and
they start believing in you. When you start convincing them, they start believing. It's a constant persistence. But for the digital media, the game is a little tough. You have to use a lot of graphical, like I had to experiment thumbnail presentation, good fonts, continuous. Every day I put out 2 stories on my Instagram story, updating people, resharing the old stuff. I did spam a lot of them for like a couple of months with my shows. You have to take that risk. But your presentation on that, because YouTube, you can't do much. You can't really push by buying the followers because it's very expensive. YouTube subscription buying is very high. It goes organic, the better. And long form content takes time. Like till now, over 12 months with 130 leading guests, we just have 1100 subscribers. So it took us a journey to be there. Instagram, we are just there with 5,000 followers. So it is a journey. You Twitter, if they retweet, Twitter is a niche crowd. It is limited, not to masses. So you have to experiment with your formats. We try to do that. And then you find your way over it. And consistently be there. Don't leave this game until you are done. Like, yes. It's over.
Yes. See, my takeaway on this is, I think all of us can learn something about, you know, how to market ourselves. Because some of the thoughts that she's expressed, maybe some of us may, you know, can silently follow, ask her separately, you know. I'm going to do that, particularly on Instagram.
In fact, I'm much inviting. I'm looking for a corporate tie-up into my space, and I would like to invite good podcast on my platform. Like, we want to collaboratively distribute good podcasts. If we get a corporate support to us, we want to expand it at a larger scale. So we want all the podcasts, because I think most of the podcasts are dying. They don't know how to market. They're like, we don't get views. We're not getting downloads. Koi sun nahi raha hai. 10 views, 11 views. It becomes hassling and it becomes discouraging. So I think one can lead to help other. These aggregating platform will allow people to reach out. Like now Netflix helps. If I get my podcast on Netflix, I feel confident to show off, listen, I've done it for Netflix. So that's how is the power of an umbrella brand over just the individual efforts that we make.
Yeah, collective efforts always leave, like,
it helps. It helps create a better product.
Santhani has a question. Like, she has raised her hand. So Santhani, you can unmute yourself.
Hi Vivek. Hi Anku.
Hi.
Thank you for noticing me raising my hand. And I'm sorry, Anku, I cannot switch on the video because, as you said, kitchen podcast. I'm right now in my kitchen, which is not really in a good shape that I can switch my video on. I'm really sorry about that.
That's kind
of probably that is why your idea of kitchen podcast really struck me. You know, just right at the heart of it.
It's a good theme we have. We should show the world that where women work to get the men there. The reason why,
you know,
men
are. Frankly, I think that if a kitchen podcast kind of a series can come up, it can actually unravel an entire world in itself. Something that not many people are
like
probably
aware. We just spoke about it. We can actually think of kitchen podcast. It has not come in the space. I've not heard of it. It's quite relatable. And it's
actually,
quite.
It has a whole lot of aspect to it, you know. It's not only cultural, it's also social, gender, X, Y, Z. You talk about any damn thing and it's there.
I think we can start this series, Shantani. I think it's a great idea. Then we'll get all the kitchen, male and female, to discuss their stories. I'm sure there are males also who have taken over the kitchen out of insecurity.
I'm sure. And especially during the lockdown when they really do not have...
The men got challenged that road. We can't do enough.
Out of necessity.
Not necessity. I think men actually enjoy the kitchen. I used to think my kitchen is my relief from my office, and my office is my relief from my kitchen. And every woman is the best manager in the world. And I will tell you that about that some other time.
Wow, so many ideas already coming in.
Yeah, Shantani, you go ahead.
Sorry. Uncle, my question is a little different from the kitchen podcast. It's about the podcast per se. two things I have to understand is, one is that when you say that the recent most trend is to go with the video podcast wherein the presenter and the speaker are available on the video, do you think it's kind of deviating from the original? I mean, I understand adaptation and changes and innovations are part of the game, but when video podcasts come in, do you think it is going away from the real idea of a podcast? That's one. And the second thing I wanted to understand is that for people who are not really sure of, say, either their voice or their face, you know, the features which you said are important for podcasts, like voice is definitely the most important part, because even if you do not show your face, your voice has to go out. That's the way you connect to people. So how do you think that people should prepare themselves in order to be ready for podcasts?
I think coming to the first question, according to my understanding, you cannot deviate out from the original purpose of podcast being audio, because if you're driving, you can't watch a video. If you're walking, you can't certainly watch video. So podcast gives a benefit to listen into the same content that is visually available. And I've seen people switch to the audio mode because they're driving or because they're walking, but they want to listen to it. So the content has always overrided this purpose. Visual is just an option people are giving, but the original purpose of it being organically audio is going to sustain, because the idea of coming to audio podcasts or podcasts for people is they're walking, they're jogging. I've seen people not wanting to listen to music, but good content on treadmill, because they don't have time and they feel like they've been preparing their next agenda over phones. Like Zoom has come in, but I've seen people do meetings on audio. They put the videos off on Zoom and just listening to each other.
Mm-hmm.
So the requirement, right, the way we are working our lifestyle would not let them completely cut off from audio, because that is the reason why podcast began. Something for which a reason things have started, they will not die out. Video will come and it'll play its own game. People will innovate, experiment. It might go off gear, then it might come back in a new form, but audio shall sustain longer. The thing that you said about people training about their voices and how they appear, going only to the audio aspect of preparing their voice, the apps that are coming out, especially after Anchor, I think 2-3 other apps are coming out, they're coming up with the equipped technology that people with a blatant voice can also get their voice enhanced over there by using their edit tools. The idea is they want to sell their app. So there are so many podcasting apps, 100 of them. So they want to post on my platform. So there won't be a hassle for anyone now to prepare their voice, because they're organically doing it with the tools they have. You just record yourself and put the edit button, and they give you choices what kind of sound you want to create out of your sound. And you know, podcasts are a different kind. I've seen some English podcasts. There was a you can search on India this Instagram, Red Button Podcast. Pralad Kakkar had introduced me to her. She is a relationship manager, Cheryl Jacob, from US, now based in India. The podcast, it has a music bed, and her intro is like, "Hi, you're listening to the Red Button Podcast. This is Cheryl Jacob, and I'm this." That's her way of bringing out. There are some podcasters who come out, like I start my show with the voice of the interviewee, the person who's being interviewed. I start by their voice. There's some podcasters who have a different way of introducing, like, "Welcome to the next episode, and here you're going to listen." They introduce what you're going to listen to that podcast. So everybody is given their freedom and creative edge to begin how you want to begin. You might jump into the content. You might have a static opening recorded and attach that in every podcast of yours. You might have a new opening every time. And sometimes people just introduce the topic and get to it. And sometimes people just go candid and be like, "Hi, you're listening. Okay, let's talk about this today." You know, just go very candid. Voice won't be a hassle anymore. But if you organically want to work on it, it's a choice. It's no more a requirement, I would say. And visually, I think it's so concerned. Yeah.
Yeah, say something about the visuals you were saying. Sorry.
If you're concerned, I think... a lot of editing element helps in video podcast. That's what helped me. If you look at the recording that I do, it comes like very dry. But once you see my show after edit, you would not even feel it got recorded that way. Like when people come on Zoom recording, they get little like, even if you get the biggest name, 1 hour of discussion, you might get lazed out, bored, exaggeration of talks. But when you edit it and you use that beautiful background and swipes and music and everything, even the host starts looking, wow. You know, it has that power of elevating the content. Right. So editing has a major role to visually enhance your product. So that helps.
Right. So the voice part, if I understand it correctly, the trick lies in experimenting again. You know, kind of record yourself and then use the apps to see which kind of
how it brings out the result. You can, but you have to be first very confident also. I believe the trick in everything to work in life is if you like your voice, like I have a husky, manly voice. So I remember when I used to do internship in Red FM, the station head would say, hey, you're good for the night shows. I would take an offense. I was too young to take such a comment from an old man. And then I was like, what does he mean? Then the RJ said, it's a compliment. He himself does a night show. So I was like, okay. So everybody has to identify where you fit in. I thought my husky voice is not good. But he said, if you kiss a mic and talk, you are the best voice to use for a romantic show. That's how he utilized the purpose of Surf. So if your voice is blunt or shrill, I think every voice has a reason to be doing a certain kind of content. Some content requires a lot. Some content requires calmness. So you should fit in your content to the kind of voice you have and the way you talk. Like I'm talking to you now, I don't talk like this. When I go on air, even if I'm the worst mood, I change myself. I just go like, hi, how are you? It's so nice to have you here. People won't even know 2 minutes back I was shouting on someone. It's also a lot of control on yourself.
That's a change in persona.
You do it. Once you get used to it, you do it. I mean, what we're doing in Zoom meetings, we do a little differently when we do. Now we're going offline. After Zoom, we're going to do a podcast on field through cameras. So we'll try something new. It's all about how you bring your
thanks, Ambu.
Thanks for the idea. We don't
we thank you so very much. I mean, I think it's just chance that I was also in kitchen at that time, and it just really struck me very quickly that kitchen, because see, we have seen our moms and aunts being there all the time, and now that we are not there all the time but intermittently and maybe as and when required, we can see the difference between how they deal with it and how we deal
with it. You have
so
to
when
see
my mom enters my kitchen.
Yes.
Yeah. See?
No, continue. When your mom enters your kitchen.
So when my mom enters my kitchen, she finds everything in shambles. She couldn't find a thing. And when I enter her kitchen, I cannot find a thing because her kitchen is so damn organized and mine is not that organized. So, you know, these are the little nuances, I would say. I have my kitchen, which is organized.
If I give you a chance to start one episode on Kitchen Podcast right now, what do you think you would start it like?
I suspect you already started because the recording is also going on.
Just think through, how would you make it a podcast if you had to make a podcast of Kitchen Podcast right now with what you said?
Okay. I didn't think that I am actually going by that way. But, you know, my idea is that with the kind of the nature of a woman's engagement changing, I think the nature of engagement relationship of woman's relationship with the kitchen is also changing. And it will be very interesting to see how that has traveled over the years. So the way we saw our grandmoms is different from our moms in some cases, for all of us who had a working mother maybe. And then now we are working in a more competitive and cutthroat kind of an environment. We are more, I would say, not away from kitchen, but we cannot really give that much time to our kitchen. And maybe when our next generation gets into their respective employment scenarios, we don't know whether the maids will actually take over, whether the cooks will actually take over. I'm not saying that's a bad thing, but there is a change. Maybe we can
exactly what I wanted track to get from what I wanted to get from you is, if there's a podcast made on Kitchen Podcast, the elements that you can use is the sounds in the kitchen. Since you wanted to know how creatively you make your podcast unique, you start your podcast with some noise which everybody generally hears. So, you know, the keeping utensils, the knocking of the egg, those elements make your podcast unique. So podcast is not just about what you talk. It is about what you hear, what you can visualize. So if you're making podcasts, keep in mind, what is the image we are creating right from the beginning? So anyone opening the first episode of Kitchen Podcast is not ready to only listen to your opinion. They want to feel it first. They should feel that I am in a kitchen. that can come through the elements around you, which you can create every time. So when you are doing a podcast, I think creating an element and an aura around it, more than just depending on the content you want to talk about, is going to be more easy to relate to people. Because we, again, listening, we're listening, we're used to listening music. So when we are getting people tuned back to podcasts, we have to maintain that element of listening that they have. So you have to use the ambience around in the right manner to get it more convenient for them. So you can use that also.
Tell me right. How. That's very interesting, Anku. I'll definitely think about it. Thank you so much.
Anku, how different is a podcast from the old All India Radio and Akashvani that we had?
You're on the point, ma'am, because I started my podcast with All India Radio Idea. I thought people have forgotten it. So I use the same mic as my cover and everything.
Okay.
But it is different, I feel, because of the... See, All India Radio was more informative, more straight-talking, more... They would just talk sensible stuff. But podcast allows you a little more creative edge, which All India Radio did not have. I think more creativity into the way you want to sing your story out. Whether you play it with the sounds or music or visuals or the way we are talking. All India Radio had a very standard, unique, classic way. I mean, no one can beat it today, even now. It is classic. So if you remember Aman Sehani or...
Exactly, I was thinking of him. I mean, nobody has forgotten him.
I want to get him on my show. But today's podcast element is also with the generation connecting to the way they talk. The Z generation that we're talking about, they have a different way of talking. So to connect with generations together, we need that mix that podcast has brought, you know. It's simple like that. When mothers say ki roti khalo, so no one understands. And mom say pizza khalo, we're like, oh, our mom is cool. So podcast is selling All India Radio in a new wrap. In a better wrap.
All right.
Okay. You don't want to review that all the time,
kitchen,
but yes.
And talking of kitchen podcasts with the new concept of the open kitchen, I mean, you have your living room and your kitchen is in there. You know, so there, that was the sound of my kitchen.
You got the reaction if you were visually into a kitchen and doing this. Trust me, you make real good. I seriously feel if I ever bring this out, my idea is if I have the fund and resource to make India podcast long and reach out in the country, one series will be kitchen podcast. All the women and men in the country should send in their audio, their kitchen podcast, and we stream it out. It's as simple as that. It's like everybody can do the radio, everybody can speak their heart out, and we can listen. See, the problem is the...
I think that's interesting. I think it's interesting because when I'm in the morning, I make tea. And otherwise, my meals are with my family. So in the process of making tea, I do many little things. And I also plan my day. And my day is not to do with kitchen work. My day is basically editing. I do PhD editing. And I do other little things like I listen to somebody reading a book. And so I do so many things and I love doing them. And I think though I may be one of the seniors of the group, I'm actually very young. I think I'm going to be 28 forever. I've decided that. I have this energy that's why you see me with my little mustache also, because I tell a story and I make a puppet. I do lots of things. And this is not because I'm a woman, but because I grew up in a gender neutral household. So my brothers can cook, my brothers can clean, my husband and my brother-in-law can cook and clean. My husband is no longer with me, but he was better in the kitchen than I was. He was immaculate. And because he was immaculate in that work, when we worked as editors, we became immaculate in our work as editors. So he brought so much with him. And these qualities come in the kitchen.
So beautiful. And ma'am, you know, so many travel bloggers have also started reblogging and getting the podcast to, you know, market. And as you said, it has become a trend. And not to make the men feel left out in the show, I think just to bring the attention back to you, we can also think of some interesting author-oriented or editor-oriented podcast series, which makes more sense. Like, for people, I think people are not used to reading out the content anymore. The reading culture is somewhere dying because I see a lot of people and youngsters say, I want to read, but I can't read. Now with Audible and all, people have more left reading. They're like, sun lenge na, padega kaun. I think there is a need for some
but
reading.
Still reading is, yeah. But reading is joyful. And we read stories to our children and then they say, mama phir se, and I might be making dal and my little one will be turning a book and saying, mama phir se. She's not little, she's 36 now. She's a published series author and she works with little children. But we can say so much when we're in a kitchen because that's our space, that's our lab. And we're in charge. And we're happy to hand over the charge to our husbands, especially mine, who was immaculate. But I think the kitchen idea is so exciting because it makes a lot of sounds and hopes and even fragrance. You know, yes. It's the smell of garlic or of sweet things cooking or anything. I think the kitchen idea is amazingly awesome.
Something awesome. We created today. At least I wish this manifests someday.
Yes, yes. Let's make it come true. Let's do it.
I'm sure your zeal, your enthusiasm will definitely get you the corporation that you're looking for.
I think food and cooking is a topic which everyone relates to. You just have to mention it and the whole thing, even guys, I mean, it's not that they stay out of the kitchen or they do. I mean, food is so exciting for them, as we all know. And for us also, it's a way of showing, I feel it's a way of showing our caring or loving or whatever. And if they are cooking even better, as Denise says, I mean, it's fantastic if you have someone who, you know, worked along with you in the kitchen. I mean, that's one of those rare things.
That's beautiful.
Yeah. So I think it's very, I mean, this is a topic which, I mean, everyone would like to sort of work on in some form or the other. And everyone.
Why not? If we can formally bring this up, Vivekha and Venkatraman sir, we will come back to you with this.
So we'll get you the recording, okay? And then you can do whatever you want, okay? We know you're very good at mixing all that, and then, you know, there is the audio, and then you can do whatever you want.
It would be very interesting to have editing and cooking at the same time.
Well, it's already started, as I said. The kitchen podcast has already started. Am I right?
And also during COVID times, how things changed. I mean, I hated going to the kitchen. I used to stay away from it. And I realized in COVID time, every day I just enjoyed the whole process of cooking. All over again, I was doing new dishes and, you know, because there was no maid, no one else. The whole experience changed. So this whole idea of, oh, I'm, you know, not going to end it because that expected of me, like as a woman, always to be in the kitchen, I'd stay away from it. And during COVID, I rediscovered the joy of cooking. And it was so fantastic. So I think these stories are also there.
You know, now this is what we are going through now, Vivek sir, Venkatraman sir, of everybody participating is what happens in a podcast. Everybody wants gets easy to speak. Otherwise, if you're formally doing something, you think, you write, you try to articulate. But when you're on a podcast, on an informal space, you just want to say. And this entire conversation becomes a listening element. So I think that's how you have yourself defined it, what I was trying to explain with so many words. So thank you for making that happen. Thank you all for being here. And I'm surely not going to leave this kitchen podcast idea here. I'm going to work on this and come back only to you guys to initiate that.
Angu, you know what would be interesting? To have us editing while we are cooking.
Oh, wow.
I have a laptop open. You're cooking, you're putting something, you're giving a tarka on the fire, and you're editing a paragraph.
Then let me promise you one thing. I'm working on my website. I want one podcast from your team to come on my website, which I'll help create. I'll take Jyoti's help to reach you guys in what kind of content I'm expecting from you guys. Just record yourself and send it to me. It is my job to bring it out with the visuals and with your audios into it. And let me publish it, your group podcast, on my platform. It's not a big platform, but whatever we manage to create, we'll be happy to host it as a representation. Somewhere we can.
Can you put in your contact details here? Yes, so people can pick it up from here on the chat.
We will put it. How do I? Can Jyoti help write it there? He has my details. Because I'm on mobile.
Jyoti?
Is he there?
Yeah, I will.
Can you just
email dalna hai kya?
No, no, just put it in the chat, no?
Email.
In the chat. Yeah.
What do we put in the chat? Sorry.
No, I am putting her number like
an email, right?
Email, right. Instagram, Twitter, what? I am sure you will have.
I've already put the Instagram. I've already put the Instagram. I'll.
Yeah. Instagram.com India Podcasts.
So, Anku, that was a very refreshing, very interactive and energetic session, I would say, without a PPT. And lots of interaction. And regarding this kitchen podcast, I think we can do a trial episode as part of our travel series. Because I have been thinking of doing a session with a chef who went to Uttarakhand and he spent 1 month on the road, like traveling and traveling and cooking, both things were going on. So if we manage to invite him to our show, maybe that episode can be some kind of a trial episode for the kitchen podcast thing.
That's very interesting.
And we wish you all the best for all your endeavors, and we do look forward to future collaborations.
Why not? Please stay in touch, and I would love to make it larger than what I can. Because all I want to is create something and leave behind. So I hope this can happen and we can all be part of that family somewhere.
Sure. It's a community that keeps on growing every week, and we have been doing it consistently. 48 episodes we have done, and just as you mentioned about the name being important, like we have managed to invite some very big names for our travel show, and maybe because the name of our group is Indian Copy Editors Forum.
We are almost like brother and sister now.
You're part of the family. Welcome to the family. Yes.
Sure, everyone will love your energy. No? You got something there in you. Definitely. Picked up something from Ram Shankar.
Morning breakfast. My mom gave me some Bihari breakfast today. That is what is
something from Sri Sri.
So here again, you have your kitchen podcast thing happening.
Yeah, I know. I think this
you should really go ahead with that. And please do, Vivek, and please make it happen, because I think it's very interesting.
Let's not leave it to the NFT today and make it larger.
All age groups would be interested in this.
Wow.
Because I'm sure, you know, because the kitchen and...
I think the men are thinking that why are women so much full of themselves? Why can't they think of us who's organized it?
I'll tell you my part, you know. When I was young, when I was doing my PhD, I was actually trying to learn cooking, and I used to cook fairly well. Okay. Now, after I got married, I was completely spoiled. I don't even remember what is what. Okay. Oh, I don't even know what is what. I've reached the stage. But my wife cooks very well. And every session, when you know, whether it's morning or lunch or dinner, when I sit there, and now I'm 57, okay, you know, every time I eat, I feel what fantastic thing this culture is. Okay. I mean, nowhere in the world, I think, we have this kind of a variety, this kind of a taste. I mean, Indian cooking is something absolutely phenomenal. Okay. I don't think there is any part of the world where you have this kind of sophistication and perfection. We have even pickles, something as simple as pickle, we have 1,000 pickles. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
And my wife is a very good cook. I've been lucky. Okay. Spoiled, completely spoiled, I'll say. So I think multitasking starts in the kitchen.
I think most men are, in Indian men are completely spoiled.
That's a good point, multitasking starts in
the kitchen.
Yeah. I like the way people are having ideas about life in kitchen. Yeah, so beautiful. We'll get someone on the show again and we'll invite all of you for that. It'll be interesting to have a kitchen podcast with you.
Yeah.
Thank you all. I hope a little bit of takeaway will be there. And we shall stay connected. Thank you for your time.
Yeah.
Thanks. It was a nice session.
Thanks, Anku. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, Anku. Thank you.
Next Sunday, we will probably have the session on cybersecurity. And for the travel series, we will have Dr. Amit Samarth. Like, he is the only Asian who has done a Trans-Siberian cycle race. 9,100 kilometers, and only 7 people in the world have done this race. So he is the only Asian. He's a doctor by profession. So I think that session is going to be very interesting. Please be there. I would request more of you to come and take a break. That's why we call that series Break Free. Take a break from work Saturday evening 4 p.m. for the travel show. Have a nice day, everyone. See you next week.
Thank you, everyone. Bye.